When gentlemen discuss the pulchritudity of ladies, they have no need to speak of rudery for ages. A proper chap will doff a cap and never cop a slap, because the lady knows a topper type will always stop a gutter snipe. Take the modern sportsman, for example. They have no wish to sample, just grab a bloody armful of flesh or cash or hooters and take and dash off like looters. Suitors they are not, polluters on the spot. When the sporting bourgeoisie discuss the fairness sex you see, it really is a rum-ill display. When reporting what they see, most romantically, this is the sort of thing that they say. Won't you smash it? Won't you smash it? Give there any 90s hanging out the back of it. Modern mores and British sport combine to bring you such crushing bores. Won't you smash it? Won't you smash it? And no, they're not referring to a racket. Now get your hairy hands off her pearly glands at once. Let your daughter in the clubhouse, Mrs. Worthington. Don't let your daughter on the field of play. The red hops may get her in the red tops for a while, but then red spots may appear around her nervous smile. She may use Mr. Clifford to get on the light match charmer list, but what you really need would be a bloody good pharmacist. So don't let your daughter in the clubhouse, Mrs. Worthington. Don't let your daughter on the field of play. Take her to the walls of the old Rivoli bar. She'll always look privileged in Harper's Bazaar. And for pity's sake, don't let her into China Whites. They'll ply her with a Balthazar and say, won't you smash it? Won't you smash it? Go there any 90s hanging out the back of it. The jargon of the crease is now the jargon of the street. The blues who fired fours, now pimps who squire whores. Won't you smash it? Won't you smash it? And no, they're not reverting to a racket. Get your hairy hands off her pearly glands this instant, sir!